Okay, here we are with the test, chapter 3 test, capitolo 3, and we're in part 2b. In this particular exercise, you're supposed to list any five things that you find in this picture here. So I see una giacca, for example. I see dei pantaloni, some pants. I see some shoes, so delle scarpe. How about that backpack? Lo zaino. Or uno zaino, oops, zaino, and about a watch, un orologio, okay? There's five examples. Dell'intruso, always fun. Which one doesn't belong? Capire, leggere, correre, correre doesn't fit. Rispondere all'email, dipingere, scrivere, this one doesn't fit. Prendere un caffè, seguire, okay, to take a coffee, doesn't fit. This one was a free one because it's just not clear enough. This one, these two things happen often, this doesn't, so raramente. And then finally these three, you're not going to use pulire. That's 336. On 316 here, articoli di abbigliamento, you're supposed to write the correct definite article, dei, dei, and delle. Similar to our previous activity, the important thing to note is that you have to determine what the gender is the word masculine or feminine? You also have to determine what is it singular or plural? So cravate is the plural word ties. It's a feminine word, I can tell by the E there, so I'm going to say delle cravate. Feminine plural. Ghiacce, jackets. Delle again. Scarpe, delle again. Blue jeans, masculine plural. Pants, masculine plural. Backpacks, masculine plural with a word that begins, a noun that begins in a Z, so that's dei. Magliette, this is t-shirts. That E indicates to me that it's feminine plural, so I'm going to say delle. Same goes for felpe. Some sweatshirts. And the last two are both dei because they are masculine plural words. One begins with a vowel, one begins with an S plus consonant. Those are your answers for 316. This last one here, you have to recognize the plural goes into the singular. So you're going to say here, jackets turn into una giacca. Okay. Vestiti would be un vestito. A zaini would be uno zaino. Magliette is una maglietta. Va bene. A gonna, una gonna. And a maglia, a sweater, una maglia. All right. When it comes to writing profiles, last section. Let's say I want to write a profile about my mother. I would say, mia madre si chiama Shirley. Okay? Her age, lei ha 60 anni. She is 60 years old. Her birthday, il suo compleanno. Her birthday, il suo compleanno, e, please put an accent on that, il is the, and tre, maggio, birthday is the 3rd of May. Okay, now I'm going to say her description, lei è bassa, I'm describing a girl, so the O changes to an A, e, this is the word and, I can say intelligente, she's short and she's smart. What does she like to do? Le piace, L-E here, not L-E-I, L-E, that's an indirect object pronoun. Le piace, and how about we just say she likes to cook, cucinare, okay? And the last part, what about your own personal profile? Well, that's going to be mi chiamo, one of the first things you learned in Italian 1, and your name. And then secondly, we're going to say o blank anni. And here you're going to put your age, okay? Here's your birthday, il mio compleanno. My birthday is the, e il, give me a day, give me a month, okay? Next one, You're going to say io sono, I am blank a blank. Give me two adjectives there. Io sono, I am. And then lastly, mi piace, and then something you like. How about I say mi piace mangiare? And there you have it. Okay, well, ragazzi, that concludes the review of the Chapter 3 test. I hope that you find this helpful, and go over it. You can go back, you can go forward, you can fast forward, rewind, pause. Use this to your advantage, please, as you review not only for the makeup of this test, but also for the final. In bocca al lupo. Ciao.